Okay, thank you. So my name is Eetu Heikkilä. I'm a research scientist at VTT. My work focuses on safety and reliability engineering, especially on automation and increasingly autonomous systems. We have had today many great presentations about how AI is a key enabler for increasingly intelligent and also autonomous machinery, but of course we have also heard many notions how AI is an issue from the safety perspective, and it brings new uncertainties and it brings new kinds of risks into the picture of autonomous machinery and mobile equipment. Now when we are introducing new uncertain risky elements into a technology, what happens is that different regulators start to regulate things, and basically engineers in Germany start writing standards. So that's what I'm talking about today. So what are the safety-related regulations and standards that we can expect in the future? There are not too many yet, but some are emerging. And I'll be especially focusing on the upcoming EU regulation and then some of the industry standards as well. But before going deeper into the requirements, maybe an anecdote of a kind related to the research on AI safety in the academia at the moment. We've been kind of screening this domain at VTT for a couple of years now, and it's quite interesting to see that there are basically these kind of disciplines that produce most of the research related to AI safety. So in academia there is a lot of research on this kind of very general AI safety issues that go to the ethical things and this kind of super intelligence considerations. And then we have the medical sciences and the car industry. Obviously they have the money to put into the research, and also they kind of want to show the results of their research in a public way. But what's interesting is that there's quite little research on the safety of industrial application of AI. Maybe it's just not public, so that it's done internally in companies, or maybe there's less funding, for example, to do that. But we see that there is certainly room for research in this area, which we have seen today that is very important and interesting from the industry point of view. Okay, but then going to the regulations, I'll be starting from the European regulation, and the hot topic here at the moment is the quite new regulation proposal. I think the first version of this came out in April or something like that. So it's called Laying Down Harmonized Rules on Artificial Intelligence, or the so-called AI Act. And this is basically, it's just a proposal. It will take a long time before it will be EU legislation, but when it will be approved, then it will be binding for all the member states, so it will be touching basically almost all of us who are developing these systems. And when you look at this document, the first thing that you will probably notice is that the definition of AI is very wide in this document. So it starts with machine learning, as you would expect, different types of machine learning approaches, but then there are also things like logic, knowledge-based approach, there are things like expert systems, statistical approaches, Bayesian estimation, so almost everything. So I'm not a lawyer, I don't know how to interpret this correctly, but maybe the question that arises is that is almost all software in the future considered as AI. I think this will lead to a lot of debate before the actual regulation will be approved in the future. But what this document already provides, and I think what is something that will probably remain similar, that is here, is that it's this kind of a risk-based approach on assessing AI systems. So there is basically this kind of categorization of the application. Starting from the bottom of this pyramid, there are these minimal risk applications, like using AI in video games or spam filters or that kind of applications, and those will be considered as something that can be basically omitted, or there will be just some kind of guidelines or codes of conduct. Then there are these limited risk applications like chatbots, emotion recognition, basically systems where it comes down to transparency, so that the users just need to understand how the system operates and that they are actually dealing with an AI system. The procedure here will be probably something like the GDPR that we have already in place. But then the two highest levels, let's look at them in a bit more detail. So the highest level of risk is basically unacceptable systems which are completely prohibited. And one might jokingly say that this is everything that China is already doing. So it includes this kind of systems that do, for example, social scoring or some kind of assessment of trustworthiness of people. Basically something that would be violating the European understanding of fundamental rights of people. But then from today's events point of view, the high risk category will be definitely the most important one, because in the AI Act proposal, all machinery basically is considered high risk systems. There are many other things as well included here, like biometric identification, applications related to employment or management of workers, for example. But basically the idea is that AI systems that are considered high risk need to undergo this kind of a conformity assessment procedure with a third party assessment body. So they will be required to bear the CE marking, basically. There are also some requirements that this document sets for the high-risk AI systems. So basically one important one is related to this transparency once again, so that the user should be able to understand and control how the AI, high-risk AI system operates. There are also for example, requirements for quality and risk management systems that need to be in place in organizations that develop these high-risk systems. I would say that many statements in the current version are still quite vague or unclear. For example, how the approval process should be carried out, or how the transparency, for example, should be evaluated. But still, these kind of general guidelines are there. And of course, there are things that organizations maybe should already start considering, for example, related to the quality and risk management systems. Another important document in the machinery sector is of course the machinery directive. There will also be a new version upcoming sometime in the future. It will be a regulation also, and this is, well, basically in line with the AI Act. So artificial intelligence is mentioned there, and it says that then the machinery product is considered high risk and the conformity assessment is needed. Okay, then I'll show just a brief glimpse on the industry standards side. What is going on there? I'm focusing here on ISO only. In the ISO, International Standards Standardization Organization, there are some documents related to AI already available. So there is a special committee dedicated on AI related standardization. It's been around already for quite some time, so it's obviously a slow process to do this kind of standardization work. And basically most of the documents that have been published so far are this kind of technical reports, so they are not exactly prescriptive standards as such. But I've highlighted here some interesting documents that are already available that might be of interest to some of today's participants, for example, related to the bias of AI systems and then this trustworthiness aspect. But as you see, most of the documents that are currently available are mostly this kind of overviews or vocabularies, stuff that is basically laying down the foundations for future standards. But there's a lots of things going on at ISO, for example. They are preparing many documents related to AI, so there are many standards in different phases of publication. Some are at very early stages, some are more closer to being published. I've again here just highlighted a couple of documents that seem interesting. Some are at very early stages still, but there will be standards, for example, related to the functional safety aspects, or for example, how to assess the machine learning systems. But it remains to be seen which ones of these will be approved in the end. In addition to these standards that come from the actual dedicated group that is focusing on AI, of course there are also the domain-specific standards which need to change to adapt to the AI emergence of AI systems. For example, in the machinery safety sector, there has been published this document that includes some considerations how AI should be interpreted from the machinery safety point of view. So here it basically says that the current practices can be used for risk assessment, risk reduction, as long as the AI is limited so that it operates within predetermined boundaries. But this is also just a technical report, so it's not a binding standard as such. So to conclude my presentation, as we have heard today, safety of AI systems is of course a key issue in development of intelligent autonomous mobile machinery, and as I showed, there are lots of regulations and standards that are emerging, but many of these are still very much living documents. They are being developed, and well, of course, always this kind of standardization work somewhat lags behind the development of the technologies. But it is very important to follow what kind of regulations there will be to be able to then comply with these standards when they come into place, so that we can build systems that can then actually enter the market. Thank you.